This video presents the most important publishing sets for batch publishing IFC document sets. By using the Open IFC standard, architects can create multiple publisher sets tailored for specific engineering requirements. In this example, we'll create three different IFC publisher sets, each dedicated to share design information with different engineers. First, we have to create dedicated model views which display only the necessary building information we want to publish. Here you can see the architectural model which contains the entire building design which is relevant for the architectural design. This includes surface finishes, openings, and so on. This is the load-bearing model. This displays only the load-bearing elements and structures of the project, such as the structural core of columns, beams, and slabs. None of the openings or suspended ceilings are displayed here. This will be shared with structural engineers. Here you can see only the 3D zones of the project, with the zone stamps displaying various zone categories necessary for heating and ventilation design. Let's display the project organizer. Here we can edit and manage all the publisher sets. We can publish multiple sets with a single click. ARCHICAD will regenerate the sets from the central building information model, so all published sets are always up to date and include all last-minute changes in the design. Here's the IFC export container, which contains the three model views shown earlier, to be shared with the three different stakeholders. We can use different custom-tailored IFC translators for the different model views. This will ensure that the IFC requirements of the receiving parties will be considered and met. For instance, if the MEP engineers use a specific application, such as DDS-CAD MEP, we can choose this translator when exporting the 3D zones and zone stamps. We can select the Tekla Structures IFC translator when publishing the structural elements of the model. We'll use the General Export translator to publish the architectural model view. This translator can be used when we have no further information on the application used by the receiving party. Please remember that by using IFC translators, we can optimize and fine-tune the information shared with other stakeholders. Using the Translators option, we can check or find out more information about the translators. Using the Elements to Export option, we can define the set of elements to be considered during the publishing process. The Translator for Export list displays all available translators. The Description field provides additional information about the selected translator. The Settings field displays the most important translator settings. We can also edit the translator settings or even create new translators. This is useful if we want to further fine-tune the content of the publisher sets or if the receiving party has additional specific requests. To do this, let's navigate to the IFC Translators dialog box. Let's see an example of how to create a custom type mapping to use with the architectural and structural models. Let's select the General Export translator that we specified to be used with the architectural model. The Conversion presets displays various preset lists. These lists contain the components of the translators. The translators can use multiple preset lists. There are ready-made presets that can also be edited, and new presets can be created as well. This so-called type mapping plays an important role, making it possible to associate element classification with IFC types. The ARCHICAD element classification defines what kind of additional metadata, known as ARCHICAD properties, are assigned to the element. By using translators, we can associate dedicated type mapping with dedicated building model views. The most important advantage of presets is that we can use and combine only the relevant and required element parameters when exporting or importing IFC model data. Let's see how to use type mapping in practice. The type mapping dialog lets us define the IFC type of individual ARCHICAD elements. Let's have a closer look at the settings of NJB type mapping architectural. The list of the ARCHICAD element classifications of the project is displayed on the left side. Let's select the window classification. We can check and edit the corresponding IFC type on the right side. Here we can decide what IFC type to associate with specific ARCHICAD elements during the IFC export. For instance, all ARCHICAD window elements will be translated to IFC window type. Now let's see how to add window dimensions and fire rating information to the exported IFC file. This can be edited in the property mapping preset of the translator. Here is the existing NJB property mapping architectural property mapping. Let's use the Map IFC Properties for Export option. Let's select the IFC window style. You can see that mapping rule has been added to the name of the window. Let's check out the rule content. Three different types of information have been inserted here using separators. Let's see if this mapping is correct. Using the IFC Project Manager. Please note that the additional information is displayed next to the windows. This is important because the receiving party specifically asked for this kind of information. Here's another example for element mapping for a structural model. Let's display the IFC translators and select the Tekla Structures Export Translator. We would like additional info for the load-bearing slabs and walls, and would like to display the main dimensions as well as the fire rating of these elements. Let's display the NJB type mapping under Type Mapping. After selecting the slab, we can see that the corresponding IFC type is IFC slab. If we select the wall, we can see that IFC wall is the corresponding IFC type. Let's display the property mapping and see the previously created NJB property mapping. Select the IFC slab type. Please notice that the name data has been altered by adding a mapping rule. We can display and also edit the content of the mapping rule. Select the IFC wall type. Also, please note that the name has been altered by adding a mapping rule. Before publishing, we can verify the actual effect of the previous settings. Let's display only the load-bearing elements in 3D. Display the IFC Project Manager. The Type Product list displays the additional information next to the slabs and walls. Such additional information may be necessary for the structural engineers to design the load-bearing scheme of the building. Please remember that the element type-related settings can be edited through the Map IFC Properties for Export dialog. Once all element mappings are correct, we can publish the IFC sets using the organizer. ARCHICAD enables you to define and use multiple property mappings within the same design project. These can be associated with multiple IFC types, which makes it possible to fine-tune the content of the published IFC sets in order to satisfy all the requirements of the engineers.